नमस्कार, स्वागत है आप सभी का एक बार फिर से एनसीईआरटी के लाइव फोन इन कार्यक्रम में। साइंस के इस कार्यक्रम में हम बातचीत करेंगे टिश्यूज पर। आप सभी जानते हैं कि प्लांट में टिश्यूज होते हैं, एनिमल टिश्यूज होते हैं, पर इनमें फर्क क्या होता है और भी टिश्यूज से जुड़ी हुई बहुत सारी बातें हैं जो हम इस सेशन में करेंगे। नवी कक्षा के सभी छात्र इस वक्त हमें देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल नंबर 9 पर, और अगर आपके पास कोई भी सवाल है तो बेझिझक हमें भेज दीजिए dth.class9@cit.nic.in पर। अगर आपको जानना है हमारी प्रोग्राम का शेड्यूल, टाइम टेबल, तो आप सभी हमारे वेबसाइट पर जा सकते हैं CIET या फिर स्वयं प्रभा की वेबसाइट, और वहां पर हमारे शेड्यूल मौजूद है सभी डिटेल्स के साथ, तो आपको सारी जानकारी वहां मिल जाएगी हर तरह की कि कौन सा सब्जेक्ट, कौन सा क्लास और किस वक्त आने वाला है ये सेशन, ये सभी जानकारी है वहां पे। तो आइए हमारे एक्सपर्ट से मिलते हैं जो कि हमें टिश्यूज के बारे में जानकारी देंगे। हमारे साथ हैं मिस्टर सुशील कुमार, स्वागत है आपका सर।
नमस्कार मैडम।
नमस्कार सर। सर है PGT इन बायोलॉजी, केंद्रीय विद्यालय अलीगंज लखनऊ से। तो आइए सर से ही पूछते हैं। सर, जो प्लांट टिश्यूज होते हैं जैसा कि मैंने बताया और एनिमल टिश्यूज होते हैं, इन दोनों का आप कुछ फर्क बता सकते हैं?
देखिए, हमारे बच्चों ने लास्ट चैप्टर में जो इसके पहले पढ़ाया गया था सेल के बारे में पढ़ा था, और उन्होंने जाना कि सेल्स क्या होती हैं। इस जो हम जिस टॉपिक पे अभी डिस्कस करने जा रहे, इसमें हम टिश्यू की बात करने जा रहे, लेकिन जैसा आपने कहा कि टिश्यू तो इंसान में भी पाया जाता है और इसके साथ साथ और लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म में, एनिमल्स में एज वेल एज प्लांट में पाया जाता है। सो पहले मैं आपको एक छोटी सी बात बताना चाहूंगा कि व्हाई देयर इज ए नीड टू डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द टिश्यू, बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दैट इन द यूनिसेलुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक अमीबा द होल लाइफ प्रोसेसेस बीइंग कैरीड आउट इन द सिंगल सेल, बट एज सून एज देयर इज द मल्टी सेलुलरिटी अकर, एज सून एज द ऑर्गेनिज्म बिकम कॉम्प्लेक्स, देन देयर इज ए नीड टू सम टिश्यूज टू डू द लाइक गैसियस एक्सचेंज, लाइक इन द हेल्प इन द ग्रोथ एंड मूवमेंट, लाइक इन द रिप्रोडक्शन, लाइक इन द एक्सक्रीशन। सो टू फैसिलिटेट वेरियस प्रोसेस दीज ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड, और दीज प्लांट द कम्प्लेक्स प्लांट और एज वेल एज ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड द टिश्यू, एंड एज द नेम टिश्यू, टिश्यू इज ए ग्रुप ऑफ सेल, वी कैन से दैट टिश्यू ऐसी कोशिकाओं का समूह होता है जिनकी ओरिजिन अर्थात उत्पत्ति समान हो, जिनके फंक्शन अर्थात कार्य कहना भी समान हो। इसके अलावा ये एक ग्रुप में मिलके एक निश्चित कार्य को करें, तो ऐसे टिश्यू कहलाते हैं। अब आपने जैसा कि कहा कि हम प्लांट में भी टिश्यू पाए जाते हैं एज वेल एज इन द एनिमल्स देयर आर द टिश्यू, सो हाउ द टिश्यूज इन प्लांट एंड एनिमल्स आर डिफरेंट। सो एज वी ऑल नो दैट प्लांट टिश्यूज आर क्वाइट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द एनिमल टिश्यूज। हाउ एज वी ऑल नो दैट प्लांट डू नॉट मूव फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस, दे हैव द सेडेंटरी हैबिट। Most of the cells in the tissue in plant, they provide a mechanical support because most of the cells are dead and strength to the plant. So the tissues of the plant are help in to the plant in the strength as well as support. Therefore, the plant tissue are majority comes in the group of the dead category. As well as अगर हम एनिमल की बात करें, so we have seen that the animal move from place to one place to another and need more energy than plant. So most cells and tissue in animals are living cells. If we discuss in another way, then the growth of the plant takes place in certain region. There are the some specific region where the growth of the plant takes place. We know these regions are known as meristematic regions, and the meristematic regions have meristematic tissue, and the properties of the meristematic tissue as these tissue divide and help in growth, and as well as there are some tissue that comes in the category of permanent tissue, and when the mesenchymatic tissue lose the capacity to divide, they convert into the, they differentiate into the permanent tissue. On the other hand, if we see in the plant, in the animals, the growth of animal is more uniform, so the animal do not have the separate dividing and non-dividing cells. Animals have organs having specialized functions, so the organs have specialized tissue. As our student also know that group of the cells form the tissue, and same type of tissue form one organ, and many organ form the organ system and whole body. So this is the whole story of the complexity of the plant tissue as well as animal tissue. If we discuss about the plant tissue, then the plant tissue consists of the two parts. One part is known as meristematic tissue, and another group is known as permanent tissue, as we discussed earlier. So the cells which are capable of cell division comes in the category of meristematic tissue, and the cells which have the mature cells and they are incapable of cell division, or they lost the capacity to divide. So these cells comes in the category of permanent, and group of the cells form the permanent tissue. Again, the permanent in category of the permanent tissue, they may be the simple, they may be the complex. So if the there is the simple tissues and the tissue composed of single type of cell, only single type of the cells are found, then the simple permanent tissue. If the tissue have the more than one type of the cells, then the permanent tissue is known as complex permanent tissue. Again, the simple tissue, since consists of single type of the cell, they may be parenchyma, they may be collenchyma, they may be sclerenchyma. So in the later part, we will discuss about these, because the parenchyma are thin-walled and have the air spaces between them. In comparison to collenchyma, they did not have the more spaces, and they have the deposition of the pectin, and sclerenchyma are totally dead cells. So in later part, we will discuss about it. If the complex tissue again are of two type. One group is known as xylem, and another group is known as phloem. And in the xylem, there may be the four part, tracheid, vessel, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fiber. And in case of the phloem, sieve tube, companion cell, and phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. So this is the whole idea or whole story of the one in the nutshell about the plant tissue. So if we will discuss about one by one, then meristematic tissue are of three type. First of all, our students should know about what is meristem or what are the properties of meristematic tissue. So the cells of the meristematic tissue are living. The cells of the meristematic tissue are isodiametric. The cells of the meristematic tissue did not have any space, means without intercellular space. The cells of the meristematic tissue have the dense cytoplasm. The cells of the meristematic tissue, since they have to divide, they have the prominent nuclei and as well as plastid in the form of protoplastid or proplastid. So these are the property of the meristematic tissue. But one thing should be clear, the meristematic tissue devoid of the vacuole. They did not have the vacuole, they lose the vacuole in the earlier stage, because the meristematic tissue have to divide and redivide. And for divide and redivide, they need more energy, more protoplasm. That is why the meristematic cell have the dense protoplasm, prominent nuclei, and there is no vacuole. So these are the properties of the meristematic tissue.
Okay, sir, although I know we are talking about plant tissues, and meristematic tissues is one of the main parts of plant tissues, but is it also found in animals?
No, these meristematic tissue are not found in the animals. The term meristematic tissue did not apply to the animal in case of the animal. If we want to observe the meristematic tissue, then our student can perform a simple experiment. They take the onion and at the base of the onion bulb, they put the onion in the glass or some other vessel, likewise in the PowerPoint presentation slide. And after 3 to 4 days, they will be able to observe the tiny roots, white color roots will came from the onion, and these roots have the apex of these roots have the meristematic tissue, means the tissue which are able to divide and de-divide. When the meristematic tissue become mature, then after some time they lose the property of divide and re-divide, and they form the permanent tissue. So permanent tissue are of two type. They may be the simple permanent tissue and they may be the complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue again may be of the, they may be the parenchyma, they may be the collenchyma, they may be the sclerenchyma, and complex permanent tissue are of two types. They may be the xylem and they may be the phloem. As far as the meristematic tissue concern, meristematic tissue usually found in the growing region of the plant, like the tips of the root, stem and branch. But in the root, in case of the root, since the root, the tip of the root is protected by the root cap, so the meristematic zone is found behind the root cap. So, but in case of the stem, the meristematic zone is in the stem is found at the apex of the stem. So this is the difference between the root and stem, the meristematic zone just behind the root cap, because the tip of the root is protected by root cap or calyptra. But in case of stem, there is no such structure. So this is the basic difference. And since the meristematic tissue divide continuously and help in the growth of the plant. So if we discuss about the meristem, so meristem may be, if we take an example of any plant, the meristem may be the three type. One type of meristem is known as apical meristem. It is found in the apex of the stem and branches. It is responsible for the growth in length. If the plant grows in the length, then the meristem which is responsible, then the answer will be the apical meristem. Second one meristem is intercalary meristem, as our student will be able to see in the figure. Intercalary meristem, it is the detached part of apical meristem and found at the base of the कह सकते एंड एट द बेस ऑफ द इंटरनोड. इंटरनोड इज द रीजन बिटवीन द टू नोड्स. सो देयर इज द इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टेम, एंड इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टेम इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द इंटरनोडल इलोंगेशन, मीन्स द इलोंगेशन टेक्स प्लेस बिटवीन द टू नोड्स. नोड्स आर नोन एज द सॉलिड पार्ट ऑफ द स्टेम, एंड द रीजन बिटवीन द टू नोड्स इज नोन एज इंटरनोडल रीजन. Third meristem is the lateral meristem. As you will be able to see, lateral meristem, it is situated lateral to the longitudinal axis of the plant. ये plant आप देख पा रहे होंगे, इसकी longitudinal axis में lateral meristem पाई जाती है. And ये question बच्चों से पूछा जाता है, आगे चल के कोई भी परीक्षा देंगे, even 11, 12 के बाद भी. What is the function of the lateral meristem? The function of the lateral meristem is this meristem help in the growth in circumference. And the example of the lateral meristem is cambium and corcambium. Cambium and corcambium are the example of the lateral meristem. Now, we will discuss about the permanent tissue. So that as we have earlier discussed about the tissue that attained their mature form and perform the specific function, means they stop dividing. So these type of tissue are known as permanent tissue. So again, the permanent tissue are of two type, as we have already discussed: simple permanent tissue as well as complex permanent tissue. Some photograph are will be seeing for your doubt as well as for so that you will make a clear concept about how the simple and complex permanent tissue appears. So simple permanent tissue are the tissue which consist only of the one kind of the cell, like the dermal and surface tissue. They form the external tissue, they form the protective covering of the plant body. अब प्रोटेक्टिव कवरिंग ऑफ द प्लांट बॉडी अलग अलग, अगर रूट की बात करेंगे तो प्रोटेक्टिव कवरिंग को अलग कहेंगे और शूट में अलग, तो रूट में अगर हम कहेंगे एपिप्लेमा और स्टेम में एपिडर्मिस एज वेल एज पेरिडर्म इन द ओल्डर स्टेम. सो दीज आर द क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ ए स्टेम इन विच यू विल बी एबल टू सी वेरियस परमानेंट टिश्यू लाइक कॉलिनकाइमा, लाइक पेरिनकाइमा, लाइक द complex permanent tissue like the phloem, like the xylem, and these phloem and xylem together form the vascular tissue, means vascular bundle. So each vascular bundle consists of the xylem and phloem. Let us see in detail. If we discuss about what is epidermis, so the epidermis, the word epidermis consists of epi plus dermis. Epi means above, means outside. The outermost layer of the plant body is known as epidermis, and it covers the leaves, floral parts, fruits, seed, stems and roots. Generally only one layer thick with cuticle. So cuticle is found over the surface of the leaves. Usually it is found in the over the leaves and protect the leaves, composed mostly of the unspecialized cells. And in stem there are some structure like trichomes. In the leaves there are some pores known as stomata, and in some monocots there are specialized cells. In some grasses these specialized cells are bulliform cells, and these cells are very helpful in the water stress condition in the grasses. This is the structure of the epidermis, and at the uppermost there is a cuticle, then the upper epidermis, then the there are some cushion like cell, palisade, mesophyll cell. As the ground tissue of the leaf is known as mesophyll. Bundle seed cell, these are the vascular bundle, or the these are the veins, vascular bundles of the leaves, consist of xylem and phloem, and this is the lower epidermis. And if the leaves is of the dicot, then the stomata are found over both surface. But in case of if the leaves are of monocot, then the stomata are distributed over the both surface. But in case of the dicot, the more number of stomata are found over the lower surface in comparison to upper surface, that surface directly facing toward the sun. And in the xerophytic plant, the plants that grow in the xerophytic habit or desert, the more number of stomata are found in the lower side, and there is no stomata or very less number of stomata are found on the upper surface, so that they help in the conservation of the water. So these are the special pores. Stomata consist of the word stoma. Stoma means mouth. So these are the some pores like structure, like the mouth like structure, and these structure help in the gaseous exchange. But stomata are found to be the one necessary evil, that is known as transpiration, that is the loss of the water in the form of the vapor from the stomata. So these are the stomata. You will be able to see these stomata, and stomata in the grasses are unique. They have, if you see these structure of the stomata, then the in the middle there is a pore like structure, and pore is surrounded by two thickened kidney shaped cell known as guard cell, whose inner wall is thickened and outer wall is thin. So this is the stomata of the dicot plant. But in case of the grasses and monocot, there are the these guard cells looks like dumbbell shaped. So these are the stomata, and stomata are very useful in plant. But if the number of stomata are found more, then they will be responsible for loss of the water from the surface of the stomata. That is known as transpiration.
We don't have any more time left. So let's continue this class for the next session, and we'll keep the rest of the information for the next session. Will that be okay, sir?
If there are 3 or 4 minutes, then I will conclude, or whether we have any question, so that we can discuss all those questions.
So we don't have any more questions because the time is up. There's no time to take any questions. Let's continue it for the next time, and we'll wrap it up here. Thank you, sir, for this information, and for this wonderful diagrams you showed it to our students. I'm sure they enjoyed the session. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you to all the students as well. Well, science is very interesting, and we learned certain things about tissues today. And because there is more information left, we'll continue this in the next session maybe. And if you have any questions, please share it with us and keep on watching our PME Vidya channels for more information and for more sessions. So coming up next is an Urdu class for all the 9th class students, jis par hum baatcheet karenge वली की गजल पे, और कौन सी होगी वो गजल ये आपको थोड़ी देर में पता चलेगा. तो हमारे साथ जुड़े रहिए, कहीं मजा आएगा, और अपना बहुत बहुत ध्यान रखिएगा. नमस्कार.